Okay, in this video, we're going to talk about the binomial theorem. Now, on the top of your note sheet, you have a sequence of problems that look like this, and they're all very similar. Now, when I write out the answers to these, it's going to be a little bit different than what you're probably used to, but I want you to kind of follow along and look at the pattern as we go through this. Okay, if we have a to the 0, we know that a to the 0 is 1, because anything to the 0 power is going to be 1. Now when I write this, I'm going to write this kind of in the middle of the paper, and there's a reason why you'll see in a minute. But for now, let's keep in mind that a plus b to the 0 is 1. Okay? Now when we have a plus b to the first power, we know a plus b to the first power is going to be a plus b. Now I'm going to write this a little bit different here. I'm going to rewrite this as 1 times a to the first b to the 0. Plus 1 times a to the 0, b to the first, which is still equivalent to a plus b. Okay? For the next one, we're going to write 1 a squared b to the 0 plus 2 a to the first, b to the first, plus 1 a to the 0, b to the second. Okay? That is a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. Okay? In the next one, we have to the third power. Now, if we follow the pattern that's happening here, we can see that this is going to be 1, a to the third, b to the 0, because my first term is going down, my second term is going up, and then plus 3, a to the second, b to the first, plus 3, a to the third, or sorry, a to the first, b to the second, plus 1, a to the 0, b to the third. Okay? So as we're going through these, our first term is going up, our second term is going down. Okay? Our next one, we're going to have 1, a to the fourth, b to the 0, plus 4, a to the third, b to the first, plus 6, a to the second, b to the second, plus 4, a to the first, b to the third, plus 1, a to the 0, b to the fourth. Okay? And then our last row, a plus b to the fifth, is going to be 1, a to the fifth, b to the 0, plus 5, a to the fourth, b to the first, plus 10, a to the third, b to the second, plus 10 again, a to the second, b to the third, plus 5, a to the first, b to the fourth, plus 1, a to the 0, b to the fifth. Okay? Now, some of you may remember from algebra 2 and see that kind of a pattern here that we have. If you look at our coefficients for each one, we're looking at 1, these highlighted terms here. If you just look at these coefficients, they form what is called Pascal's triangle, okay? So there's a little note there at the bottom of your note sheet. This is going to be Pascal's triangle. Now, you could go through Pascal's triangle to find your coefficients for expanding these products here, but sometimes you have high numbers. So like if we had a plus b to the 10th, we're not going to want to write out Pascal's triangle all the way to find the 10th line. So there is an easier way to do this, and there's a formula for it. So if we had a plus b to the n, okay, something here a, something b, all to the nth power, what we could do to find the coefficient of our next term, okay, first of all, the first term always starts with 1. And to find the coefficient of your next term, you're going to take the coefficient of the term times the exponent of a, which is this a here, divided by the term number, okay? So I'm going to show you this in a shorter example. And yes, we have done the fifth line on the previous page, but just kind of bear with me here as we show you kind of the pattern of how to find the next term. So in order to do this, the easiest thing to do is to go ahead and write out your variable parts first and not worry about the coefficient right away, okay? Also with this problem, it is c minus 2, so I'm going to change that to c plus a negative 2, all to the fifth. That's going to make sure that your sign stays appropriate. Okay? And I apologize for the focus here. I don't know why it won't stay focused today. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to write this as blank. We'll find our coefficient in a minute. C to the fifth, negative 2 to the 0, plus blank, C to the fourth, negative 2 to the first, plus blank, C to the third, negative 2 squared, plus blank, C squared, negative 2 to the third, plus C to the first, negative 2 to the fourth, plus C to the 0, negative 2 to the fifth. Okay? All right, now, to find our coefficients, what we're going to do is we're going to look and use this formula here. We always begin with a 1 here, okay? So what we're going to do to find our next coefficient is we're going to take the coefficient of the term, so we're going to take 1, we're going to multiply it by the exponent of a, which in this case is c, and we're going to divide by the term number. So this is term number 1. So in this case, we're going to take 1 times 5 divided by 5, which is 5. Okay, to find our next term or coefficient, we're going to take 5 times 4, which is 20, and divide it by 2. 2 because it's our second term. So 5 times 4 is 20 divided by 2 is 10. Okay, to find our next one, we're going to take 10 times 3, which is 30, divided by 3, and we get 10 again. Okay, to find the next one, we're going to take 10 times 2, which is 20, divided by 4 is 5. And then the next one, we take 5 times 1, which is 5, divided by 5 is 1. Notice that if we look at our previous page, when we had a plus b to the fifth, our coefficients were 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1. And again, in this problem here, our coefficients are 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, and 1. Okay? So now we just have to do is simplify this, okay? So be careful here because you don't have two variables. We have variable and a number. So this first term is pretty simple. It's just going to be c to the fifth. Now the second term is a little bit tricky because you have 5c to the fourth times negative 2 to the first. So we have negative 2 times 5, which is negative 10. C to the fourth. The next term, we have 10 C to the third, negative 4 squared, or sorry, negative 2 squared. Negative 2 squared is 4. 4 times 10 is 40. And then we still have our C to the third. Okay? The next term, we have 10 C squared, negative 2 to the third. Negative 2 to the third is 8. 8 times 10 is 80. Oops, sorry, this should be negative 80 because it's negative 8 here. C squared. Our next term, 5 C to the first, negative 2 to the fourth. Negative 2 to the fourth is 16, and 16 times 5 is 80. C. And then this last term, we have negative 2 to the fifth, which is negative 32. So this here would be our answer to our question. Okay? All right, now sometimes you're going to be asked to find a specific term of a expansion, such as a question like this. Okay, to find any term, you're going to use this formula here. And we can find any term of a plus b to the n using the formula n factorial over n minus k factorial times k factorial times a to the n minus k times b to the k. All right, now k is called the index of your term, and basically what that means is it's going to be one less than the term that you are looking for. So if you're looking for the 10th term, your k value is 9. If you're looking for the 27th term, your k value is 26. Okay, you look for one less than the term number that you're looking for. Okay, so in this example that we're going to do, you are asked to find the fifth term of a plus b to the 10th power. Okay, so first of all, our k value is going to be 1 less than our term number. So we want the fifth term, so we're going to take 5 minus 4, or sorry, 5 minus 1, which is 4. Getting ahead of myself. Okay, so our k value is 4, And our n value is 10. That comes from our exponent here. That's our n value. Okay. So plugging this into the formula above, we're going to get 10 factorial over 10 minus 4 factorial times 4 factorial. And then our first term is a in this case, so we have a to the 10 minus 4 times b to the 4th. Okay. So the first part here, we can do this in our calculator. 10 factorial divided by 6 factorial times 4 factorial. When you plug that into your calculator, you should get 210. And then a to the 6th, b to the 4th. Okay. All right, now, what I would like you guys to do for class tomorrow is to try the following problems. These are on the notes that you printed out. So if you printed out your notes, these were kind of mixed in there that we skipped over. You're asked to expand V plus W all to the 9th power, asked to expand X minus 2Y all to the, I believe that's not to the 6th power, it was to the 4th power, so you might want to. And p minus 1 to the 12th power, you're finding the 10th term of that. Okay, so tonight you need to try these three problems on your own.